Hello friends, welcome back. My name is PK. In this video, you will learn how to use time series forecast and anomaly detection in Microsoft Power BI. So as you are seeing my screen, I have used NordPin data to create the time series forecast and anomaly detection here. So I'll show you the data. We have order detail table, product and supplier here. And we have created a line chart and forecast for upcoming 6 months using the historical data. In the second chart, we have detected the anomalies in our data. So you can see the red markers wherein the anomalies are there. So I'll show you in detail. So first, let me show you the forecast. So let me put it in the focus mode. So here you can see we have day-wise data. Now here we are showing the forecast. This gray shade is showing the lower bound and the upper bound range. And this black line is our forecasted value. In the anomaly detection, let me put it in the focus mode, this one also. We are showing this line, daily line. And these are the anomalies wherein the value is not as per the expected value. And you can see the key regions also. You can simply click. And it will show the regions in the natural language as well as in the visual form. It had a value of 11,043, which is above the expectation range. Okay. Wherein shipping company is United Package. So it is showing the chart also, the revenue of the United Package and the net revenue of the overall. So here you can see the sudden spike. Okay. There are some other regions also. You can see the title is Vice President in the sales. So here we can see this one also and the some other regions also. Okay. So that is how you can read this, and I will show you how can you get the anomaly detection and the time series forecast in Microsoft Power BI using this data set. You can use your original data. So let me add a new page here, and first I'll show you how we can do the forecast. So to do the forecast, what I will do, I'll create a line chart. So this is line chart. Let's create a line chart here. Let's make it a little bigger. Now here, what we will do, we'll go to the order detail table and we have the order date here. So let's take the order date from here. So I'll put it on the axis. I'll take normal order date, not the date hierarchy. Now I'll do the forecast for the net revenue. So I'm taking here net revenue value. So just put this here. Now I'll go to the analytics. Just go to the analytics here. I will scroll down and you can see the forecast option is there. So just click here, scroll it down and we will add a forecast line. So just click on add button. Now the forecast is added because our data is not in proper base. So we have to put the seasonality. It is not taking the automatic seasonality. If your data is in proper trend or proper cycle, so it will take the seasonality automatically. In this case, we have to enter the seasonality. So let's say I'm saying we have a seasonality, the annual pattern. So we can say the 365 days seasonality is there. So I will apply this. So here we will see the forecast, but we want to see the forecast for 6 months. So in place of points, so we will take the month. So let's take the month here. And I'm saying I want to see the forecast for 6 months. So I'll put here 6 and I'll click on apply. So you can see the last 6 month forecast here. Okay. Now, if you want to compare with the original data, so what I can do here, I am saying, okay, ignore the last 2 months and just click on apply. So it is ignoring the last 2 months. So that means it is showing the last 2 month actual value as well as the forecasted value. So you can compare the accuracy of your forecast. Now the next thing is the confidence interval. So confidence interval you can choose from here. By default it is 95. As you will increase your confidence interval, gray shade range, which is the upper bound and the lower bound, will be increased. Let me apply this. So here you can see it is now bigger. If you will decrease the confidence level, let's say 85%, then this range will be decreased. All right. So by default, let's take it 95%. That is how you can create the forecast in Microsoft Power BI. You can use the color, let's say for the forecasted line, I want to see in this color. So it will be in this color. You can change the line style. Let's say I want to show dashed line. I want to show only lines like this or none. Alright, so let's take fill here. You can change the transparency of the filling, you can just increase this or you can decrease this. Okay, accordingly it will be displayed on the chart. You can take, let's say, in the days also. I want to see the forecast for last 300 days. So it will be displayed for last 300 days. Alright friends. Now quickly I'll show you how can you use the anomaly detection and how it is beneficial to analyze the data. So let me add new page here. Again I will take the line chart, just increase the size of this, and again we will take order date and just put it on the axis. Just click here and take the order date only. Now I'll take the net revenue. So let's take the net revenue here. So this is again the similar chart, but this time we want to see the anomalies. Anomalies means some unexpected values are there. What I will do, I'll again go to the analytics and I will scroll it down, and you can see we have one new feature which is find anomalies. Friends, make sure you are using the latest version of the Power BI. If you are not getting this find anomalies option, then you should update your Power BI version. Okay, so let's add. So here you can see automatically some anomalies are highlighted in this color. So by default it is taking this 70% sensitivity, and we can increase it, let's say 90%. That means your algorithm running in the backend will be more sensitive and it will show more anomalies there. Or if I will decrease this, then you can see. Now the next is explain by. I'll explain you how we can use this explain by, but for now I'll show you the formatting option. So anomaly shape, you can change it from here. Let's say I want to take this one, and you can change the color also. Let's say I want to take red color, you can take from the more color also. Let's take this red color. Okay, so it is in the red color. And you can change the expected range style also. So you can take it in the line or you can take in the fill. So here you can see the backend it is in the fill. And you can change the expected range color also. Let's say I want to take it in the red. So you can see it is in the red. Okay, in the back end. Alright, so friends, that is how you can use this anomaly detection. Now I'll show you this explain by. First of all, I'll show you when I will click here on any value, it will show me the all possible explanation why it is high or low. So here you can see it is showing in the natural language also, and from the data model it is taking all the possible explanations. Category name, by description, country, first name, last name, and all the things. But if you don't want to get by all columns, you can use a field in explain by. So what I can do here, so let's take country here, explain by country, or I can take anything else also. Let's say I'm saying SIP name and I'm saying apply. Okay, so I have taken these two columns. If I will click now, then it will show me these two columns only. So it is showing by country, and as of now it is showing by country only because the SIP name is not relevant, so it is taking only one. Otherwise it will take only these two, so it is restricted now. Alright friends, so friends, that is how you can use this anomaly detection in Microsoft Power BI. So it is quite useful to analyze. Friends, I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe my channel to get the regular update of my videos. Thank you so much for watching.